Informing me that Anita is joining us. I don't see her yet, but if she's here. Anita, obrigado. No, I don't see her yet. So we will continue. And now.
Hello.
Yes.
Hi. You hear me now?
We hear you, but we don't see you. Yes, we see you right now. How are you? Obrigado.
Oh, thank you. I'm fine. How are you? Good morning. Bye. Actually, good morning here. I don't know where other people are, but here's good morning. So thank you so much.
Thank you to be part of this meeting. So if you allow me, we'll get into your question. You recently participated in a two-day internet live streaming charity concert, Music Lives. The concert benefited the Musician Cares COVID-19 Relief Fund, which was created to provide relief to music industry professionals who lost their jobs as a result of the pandemic. What additional measures do you think should be put in place by state, NGOs, or the private sector to ensure that emerging artists and independent cultural professionals make it through this crisis? How can we protect the most vulnerable people in the music sector, especially in Latin America? Anita.
So I think that when we, the most important thing to say, first of all, is that most of people in the society, when we talk, when they listen the world, the word artists, writers, they glamorize so much this profession. Like, they think it's only about rich singers, rich writers, and cars, and all those things that we can see on television, like in the music videos, for example. And maybe they don't know, or they forget, that they're a very big part of this group that are, first, still beginning. Second, they work on the background, after, behind the artists. So writers, people who work and who provide their lives only from the things that they wrote years ago, or I don't know, the things that are right now playing in the streamings. So it's important for the society to understand that this group of people, this class of people, it's not only about the artists and famous people that they see on television. It's way more than this. So it's important to think that when we listen this word, artists, we are talking about a lot of people, beginners, small groups, small people. There are selected for some part of the entertainment. So it's important to think, to listen and understand this part. It's not only the glamorized people. And I think that right now, of course, all the governments should have a part on the administration, only to think about the entertainment people, industry, the culture side, because right now I think people are understanding the importance of entertainment. People are inside their homes, locked. They are right now, they need right now entertainment and things for them to spend time and to make them stay home and keep home mentally healthy. So it would be very important for the government to stop and think about how can we push these people to keep doing what they do and to don't go through struggles, necessities with financial necessities. And this is very important. I think when the government listen the word entertainment, they forget how important this is for the society. And it's important to look at these people and understand how can they monetize what they are doing for the people right now to enjoy that, like, we can say, because we enjoy their times on quarantine, enjoy, like, not being so bad as it could be without entertainment, without music, without art.
So, Anita, we will come back to you, but let me give the floor to Fouzia Saïd. I will go back to Anita, because I know that she has to leave us. So, Anita, you recently made headlines for opposing an initiative in Brazil that will have drastically reduced royalties for music creators on live events. Are you concerned that in some countries, the COVID-19 pandemic may be used as an opportunity to adopt measures that could have a negative impact on the remuneration of creators or artistic freedom?
I'm very concerned about this. Actually, I think mostly here in Latin America, I have traveled most of the countries here in Latin America, and I can see the corruption is something very big here, all over the countries. The countries have a big problem with corruption in the government. So 2 weeks ago, the government here in Brazil, they tried to use the things that could be a solution, emergency solutions for resolutions for the COVID, this problem, people who are going through struggles with COVID. Some people are taking advantage of this to get into the law, to emergency laws, requiring things that are very bad for the artists. So I'm 27 years old, and I know that the internet here in Brazil has, here in Brazil and in the Latin America, with this corruption system, is the internet has a very big power. So right now I'm working on educate the people, all the class, the small writers, artists, to ask about their rights. And I'm very concerned about how this corrupted system can use this moment, this emergential necessities of the people to try to have to use some tricks to require things that can take out our rights. And how Fouzia said that I was listening here, now people are realizing that entertainment is something paid. People need to pay for entertainment because there are people working for this. There are people that are creating the things that are making us enjoy music, enjoy art, enjoy movies, series. So it's important for the audience and for the government to understand that we understand, we know our rights, and we need to improve the knowledge of this class, this group of people, to see when they are trying to be stole, when their rights are trying to be stole from our law. So things that we fought for years to have, like rights. I could fight on a debate on Instagram with one person from the government to take out the possibility of law that would reduce a lot the rights from the artists, the musicians here. And this is also very bad here in Brazil, and they were trying to put it even worse. And I needed to read, to understand, to study with lawyers, with people that are not from my knowledge, for me to fight for my people, with my visibility, with my followers. So I think it's important for the government to understand that entertainment create a lot of jobs, a lot of people depend on entertainment. So it's important, yes, it's important to pay attention on that and put our people very, very armed with knowledge to understand when they are trying to stole us. I think this is very important.
Anita, if the other panelists allow me, because I know that we have to let you go because you have other commitments. If I can ask you in very shortly, what message would you like to convene to the decision maker to reinforce the resilience of creative sector? Very short. What should be the message?
I think I think that they need to see the emergency measures, financials, what can be done for the small people. Small people are now suffering even more, and each country knows your necessity and knows how it can be done. We need to give voice for the ones who understand their parts.
Thank you, Anita, to be with us today.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. It has been a pleasure.
Thank you.
Bye. Kearney, the entry